Alright, time for some Disgaea. excuse me. So I know I said some things about, like schedule stuff. But I thought it out. And for the moment at this time, I think I'm gonna aim for 10 o'clock being the norm for when I start, whenever I do. I really do want to stream more often, so 10 to 12 is going to be the norm. The norm for the amount of time I want to stream. And I want to stream, like I said, I want to stream more often. I'm kind of winging it for this part, or for this session. I'm not too sure what to do from here. Well, I mean, I know what to do. It's just, there's so much stuff to do. I kind of want to do Cave of Ordeal. I kind of want to try to see how far I can get into that. Try to get a low number. We'll try this. Jesus. Let's see what that one zombie is. Or this guy. Level 11. He's 179. We'll give it a shot. She's the one with the most threat here at the moment. Alright. See how this goes. Probably not going to be able to do it this time around. Who's next? 86. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll definitely do that. We're not gonna be able to make this one. Yeah, that's it. Quit because, so we don't waste that mana. Mana, you know, tomato. The lower the participants, the better.
Nay.
I just gotta get one to say yay.
Nay.
It's a good level, and hopefully close by. See how this works. 59. 12. There was another one too, wasn't it? 27. Okay, this might work a little bit better. Six out. That'll work. Sagi's, let's go ahead and throw him. Oh, I grabbed him. God dang it. Okay. No big deal. We got this. I think we got this. I hope we got this. Okay. 59. Gonna actually throw this guy over here. Let's try this. That's what I was worried about. Okay. See, now he's an enemy, so that's not gonna work. Not paying attention one bit. 159, okay. Picking him quite a bit. Okay. Alright, we are going to throw Laharl over there. I always keep my phone next to the microphone, just, I don't know why. Got her futon back, so I guess she's a little happier. I'm hoping she's happy. I hope you're happy, Scarlet. She's like, leave me alone, I'm trying to sleep. Oh, Laura's dead. Okay, cool. Great. Swimming. I think I know what I need to do next time. Yeah, we'll call Molly on this one. Doesn't work this time, Dad. I'm gonna focus on something else at the moment. Might go ahead and try to get Hogmite, or the bad flan ending. Now we can get the 18. Oh, 17, okay. One yay. Let's see what the level was. We might be able to make that work. That's what I normally do. Okay. Okay. 170 or 167. Okay. actually what I really need to be doing. Okay. Might be all I'm gonna send out at the moment. Well, in the older version, I used to be good at that. I don't know if it's just different. I love the pumpkin's portrait. That guy's definitely the biggest threat. This is a good one. So this is our shopkeeper. She got called in on duty. It's also pretty good that most of these guys are really not that bad. Oh, wait a minute. I done messed up, didn't I? Yeah, I done messed up. Shoot. guess because she's a human type. That it didn't work out too well. Or maybe, no, she wasn't higher level. It had to be because she was a human type. Okay. We'll try it again. That's not good. That's not good. So 17's the absolute lowest we can go, as far as I know, for this. Literally not a single one. I know you can bribe them, but that's too simple. Oh, it's set up for 18. Oh, there's 17. Okay. Alright, try this again. Two 14, that's good. 38, okay. I can get behind this one. Thank you. See how well this goes. Dang it. No, 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 no. I was... Okay, wrong mushroom. Wrong mushroom. Looking at the wrong one. Okay. Alright. I think Lahal's the last one, right? Yep. He's probably dead. Yeah. Alright, that's going to do it, too. Alright. We gotta get some innocence, too. Like, there's a number of things I could be doing right now. Yeah, I think we need to start doing that too. Okay. Well, let's get Flan. Let's go ahead and get Flan first. We gotta get this move up a little bit. Now we've already seen the mid boss ending. That I do know we remember doing. Let me go do this too, just in case I didn't do it already. Can't recall. I'm pretty sure I did. Just in case fast forward doesn't register it. Fairly certain we already did that in the previous session. You with a gun? Fist, spears, or gun. I think I usually put a gun on her. But if she's good with fists, I'm probably better off in the long run putting a fist on weapon on her. Wow. This guy does. Let's concentrate on getting Flan right now. And then we're gonna start innocent grinding. Oh, they are literally short swords, okay. Any records? I can, okay. So now we have a couple of songs we can go through. What can we get? Those we cannot buy. Oh, it's just called Great Mob here, okay. Oh, can you not do random on this one? I guess you can't do random. What am I more in the mood for? That's just saying you can't do it as random. That's what I liked about doing in the item world. I just like had random music. Just to be silly. Okay. Well, we got a couple songs. Prince, I gotta get some stuff for them. One more, and okay, after this one, it should be it. Should be alright. We got Flan, so we can go ahead and just start innocent grinding. I just wanted to have Flan just to have a decent healer. And I mean, she's got one spell. I mean, we gotta get a level 10 item anyway. I don't even know if I still have one. Okay, we do, the common axe. Okay. Alright, time for the fun part. It really is nice. We're gonna start out slow, though. So, I'm gonna try to get that first. Oh, you can actually choose it here too, that's pretty cool. Oh, right off the bat, cool. So after this, we don't have to worry about, trying to get to the exit. So it's recommended whenever you start doing item world stuff that you want a runner and you want a person who can who's pretty good with fists, because most fist weapon skills moves the enemy target, so even if they can't kill them, they can at least get them off the exit portal if you do have an enemy on a portal, just like here, because it's a special class, it's called Gatekeeper. And they are just designated, designed to never move from that spot. And sometimes you might be in a pickle where you need him to move, but you can't just do nothing. And that's where fist weapons come in handy for that. Because, like I was saying, most fist weapon skills has, their properties have it to where you to move the enemy off that, space. So it's always recommended to have one of those and a runner. Which are a runner I never actually really use. And funny enough, this is the guy that is actually the best runner in the game you can get. Because he's a flying type, he can go through enemies. I think that's how it works in this guy one, if I'm not mistaken. He can fly through enemies, so it's recommended to get one of these and just fill him up with shoes. Because shoes adds more movement. And that's for if you never want to, if you don't have a enemy, if you don't have a gatekeeper, so you can just literally just fly in. I might actually do that after this run. Just go ahead and create one. And obviously you want a thief too, which, there's That's really all they're really good for in Disguise 1 is they can steal stats. It's not really worth it because you can't really... Because they just start out so weak. It takes a lot of effort to make a good thief. But they can now go up to a 99% chance of stealing. Most of the time, I don't even really do that. But if I want to fill every item, I guess I'm going to have to start doing that, though. Because I don't even think Thursday can go up past 50%, if I'm not mistaken. So, for example, six will probably, till I get Jennifer, six will probably be your go-to fist guy. Also, you do gotta mind the, geo effects. Usually I never run into too much trouble, but it does happen with the geo effects, where, I get into a situation where I can't just proceed because of it. This is probably not enough people. Nope, unfortunately. But luckily, everybody's weak here, so it's not too bad. Plus, that gives him a chance to try to learn Big Bang, you know, try to get his level working up. Like, at this point, since it's only one, I usually just go ahead and see what the bonus is. And just go ahead and get it. I wish, in this version, they would give you a, because, I think it was it 5 that did it first? I want to say it was 5, this guy 5 that did it first, but they actually let you do some subcategories where it's like, okay, who's your main 10? And you can, order it that way. And you can do up to 3 times with that, too. You can have, like, yeah, basically 3 times. So you can have team 1, team 2, team 3. So you can just shuffle instead of having to go through a long list. I wish they would have brought that for this version. I want to say 5 did it first. Now, I could go ahead and use an exit since we already got all the innocents we want here. But, if it's not too difficult, I try to get as many, exit doors as possible. What spells do you have? This is ice, okay. Nah, I really need to get 6's, fist weapon to build up. Oh, perspective. Probably not high enough. It's not. He might be able to jump that high. Yeah. That's fine. We got no geocache. We don't have to really worry about. Oh, That's close enough for Laharl to just... And his six should walk right into that. Yeah. So some of the names I do name some of these characters are based off of, well, I should say a lot of story, like, I like to write stories, in my head, funny enough. One day I'm gonna actually write them down and actually try to get some stories out there, but, for the most part, this guy has been the inspiration for some of the characters I've created for my stories. So, not all of them, but, like, for example, Six, it's gonna sound silly, but Six is, in my stories, is based off a ninja android. He's the sixth model. Well, he's not an android, he's a, cyborg. Because he was originally human, and then, you know, he's, like, the sixth in the unit of that. It's silly stuff. But, most of the characters I've made in the stories are based off, like, Disgaea classes, funny enough. Like, just to be silly, I'll name some of them. Matt Guy, Bell, Six, and Bibu is, characters that came from, that are influenced in my stories. Bibu is just, it's just name only, because in the stories I got, he's like, he's not a penguin at all. I'm a very silly person, I know. There's a lot of trees going on here. That was... Dang it. I messed up. Well, these are... There is another thing that these are good in this game. They are, like, one of the few that can throw... six panels. I don't remember if Majins can. I don't think Majins can. I think Majins might actually be one. Maybe. But, I know Captain Gordon is the other one I know off the top of my head that can throw six panels. Can she fly through enemies? I don't think so. Alright, let's try this again. See, that was overkill at that point. But that's okay. Alright, now we're to the boss level. So, basically, in order to get any of the bonuses, you have to kill all the enemies on the map. Just like any other level. Sometimes it can be difficult because... some of these can have islands where their enemies are, and you might not just be able to reach. This is why it's recommended to bring a spellcaster, because of the range. But luckily for us, this is pretty good, because it's not even that many enemies either. And, every 10 floors, it's always going to be an exit. No matter what, you're always going to get an exit at your first prize. It's, set that way. No matter what your item bonus rank is. Thank you. not what I wanted. I don't remember in the original Geopanos taking priority when choosing enemies. Now, there's a lot of factors going on that you can do for leveling up items and weapons. I don't know if anything was changed in this particular version of the Disgaea 1. I'm assuming it's just going to be straight up like the PC version. Well, no, that's not true, because in this version, they did change some of the innocence. The EXP bonus innocent. They did change that for the... They increased it to make it faster. I don't know. I'll have to do some hardcore research. Probably going to do it after this session. But yeah, we got our EXP one. And we're going to immediately put that on somebody. Probably Lahara, should be told. That's got Gladiator. At the moment, when you can fuse Innocence on stuff that, even if you don't have them submitted, I recommend don't doing that right away, because you want to have multiples of the same one. Later on, you can start combining them if you want, but you definitely want to have copies of the same one, because that's necessary for trying to get a maximum... Oh, what am I trying to say? Maximum... Shoot, let me take a drink. Most bang for your buck, I guess, is one way of saying it. We'll put that in there for now. Why not? Was a Gladiator in that some... No, it was not. Okay. I might go ahead and just try to get this. Try to get this Gladiator here. That way I can go ahead and use this as storage, because it's got 11 spots. I guess you really don't really need to be too concerned about saving, because it's auto-saves and you can just reload it. Yeah, we'll use one of these as soon as I come across this Gladiator, hopefully. Okay, Planet X. Oh, so you can go over here to character, and the Innocent's always going to be at the... is it the very top or the very bottom? But their name's going to be in blue, just in case you happen to just, like, miss it. Oh my god, Planet X theme is great. We'll probably just start throwing the horror towards it for right now. But really, it's just about a sheer numbers game from here on out. There's a few things you do need to worry about. I mentioned geo panels. You gotta make sure where you're stepping at, make sure you're not stepping on anything. But anything that has percentage damage, you definitely want to watch out for. And even the weakest enemies can still poison you, even if they do zero damage to you. So you do gotta watch out for that as well. Oh yeah, I said I was gonna create a demon tank. I need to do that. There we go. Okay, cool. Okay, see, he's gonna be invincible. So, we gotta try to get him off of there. See, you can run into situations like this if you're not careful. Well, I mean, you can still be careful, but you'll just run into situations like that. Oh, we can't even lift them either. And say if you have a scenario where the enemies kill the innocent themselves. Don't be too concerned about losing out on it. He can respawn at any point as long as you travel in that item. The only way you can really miss out on it is if you're at level the 100th floor. And you can't do anything at that point. At least if this guy won, there's nothing you can do at that point. This might not be good enough. Nope. We might have to take a risk here. Well, I'm not taking risks. We'll just go to another floor and hope he respawns. Yep, cool. There we go. Oh, let me check this. Okay, that's new. He's literally right there with the geo panels now. It wasn't like that before. So, they must have changed the priority of geo panels then. That's interesting. Just so we can have something to store that stuff in for right now. Now these you do want to combine right away. The EXP bonuses. I might keep this around. Well, no, we got the Common Axe. We have no reason to keep that. I'll probably just put it on her for right now. Just so she has a weapon to start with. Right, next up is Poison Knuckle. Alchemist. What was Alchemist? I don't think they were too special. Adds poison attack. Oh, that actually might be pretty decent. I really never used it myself. I'd rather have the sheer raw power than elements like that. But I mean, poison, I mean, now think about it, it might not be too bad of an idea. And those are based on the max level for them is 100. Each level represents a percentage. So, you know, for right now, like, suppose for attack mode, it's 3 right now. So it would be a 3% chance whenever you attack somebody, they'd be poisoned. But it's got to be a normal attack, if I'm not mistaken. I don't think you could, like, do special abilities and that would count. If I'm not mistaken. So yeah, we'll go after that too. Oh, but first, well, I'll remember. Put us back up. Oh yeah. Have we created a scout yet? I don't think so. I just hate that Laharl's making everybody. There's their move increase. Let me look that up real quick. Their movement might increase with per rank. No, but their jump does. But shoes also increase jumping capabilities. Really, we haven't killed enough of those guys yet. We'll go ahead and do it. We need a name. Just see what comes up. Fixer. We will name him... I don't know why I just came up with this. Because it makes no sense. Two Z's. And we got a designated runner. Which... Hold on. They are located... I don't think we actually have any other monster. No, we got the zombie. That's right, that's right. Okay, they're coming before the zombie. Got it. Did it came before the ghosts? They did. Okay. Or they come after the ghosts, I should say. So that's correct, right? Yeah. Let's go ahead and try to buy some shoes, too. But we gotta get approval for that, to buy shoes in the shop. Which I don't think that should be too difficult. Say, are you guys really gonna deny the right for me to buy shoes in this shop? Hey. I think every shoe increases movement by one. Except like the very best one, if I'm not mistaken. But they do increase in jump after a while. The scene is, oh well. Like, he's already at 9 movement now, so it's pretty set. And we can increase his movement in the assembly once he gets enough mana. At some point. Alright. This is gonna be a lot of sessions. just doing this. Kind of fitting that this song is playing in Item World right now. Because the first appearance of Item World was actually not Disgaea. It was actually basically the game that came before Disgaea. Did something similar to this. And it was called Demon World. It's not as intricate as this, but it's definitely noted that it is the first to do something like this. It's just Disgaea built upon it with Item World. But technically, in the United States, this came first, funny enough. Which is always hilarious. Like, in Japan, they made that game, Late Pursuer, before Disgaea. But in the States, or I guess North America in general, this game came out first in North America. And then another company, other than Atlus, published that game. Which is kind of funny. So you have two games from the same company in Japan. Atlus brought over Disgaea, and then a completely different company. So I guess they saw that Disgaea did well, or did decent. I don't know. I don't know what made them say, "Hey, we're gonna port that other game from these guys." It's weird how stuff like that works. But I am so glad that Atlus took a chance on Disgaea. I'll give Atlus that. They were the kings of bringing us like the most obscure RPGs at that time. And Disgaea being one of them. That would be their only I believe that's not true. They did Rhapsody, A Musical Adventure. They did bring that over for PS1 as well. So they did. I know they did two games for NES right off the bat. No Innocence. It's already what floor? 6. And I don't remember what I saved before this, so I don't want to risk it. So if I don't get anything, I don't get anything. I'll just sell it. he never usually used a runner before, should be told. But it's gonna make things a little bit easier. I mean, 6 can still do that. With this. Oh, no, he can't. Never mind. Oh, Asagi's move is 6. Or 7. That's pretty good. Can she go through enemies? If Asagi can go through enemies, then I might just be using her as a runner. I don't think she can, though. I'm gonna do an experiment. Well, no. Just in case. She cannot, okay. But I sling. I mean, I understand why, but that would have been pretty cool if she could. Then I would have had no use for that guy then. So we actually need to throw the ball. I think in Item World, they usually go towards whoever's your weakest party member that's out on the field, and I think that's actually, you can get away with that, using that as a strategy, if I'm not mistaken. That should have been expected. we're done with that, we can just sell it. Eventually, I'm probably gonna need to start grinding money again. What's next? That's the Arms Master. Which we are gonna need at some point. Don't know if this version increases their level cap or not. Plus, it's got Coach Gladiator on there, too. Yeah, that's pretty good. Alright, what's that gonna be? Oh, the default, okay. I need to bring some stealing hands with me too, start looking at some of the equipment that I don't have. Try to fill that up. Don't need to necessarily do that, but hey. I just realized he's not another island, it looks like. No big deal, we got this. That's what Thurl is for. Damn, we can just do this. Bothering me, and I can't get it. It's taunting me, too. There's nobody up there. Rather overshoot than undershoot. Even the original note looks silly. Well, this looks like a final one. This would be in Phantom Brave. Thank you. Oh, shoot. Told you. Huh. Sorry, I got a little confused there. Plus, when we kill monsters here too, it also adds to the character creation for monsters. So the more you kill, the less mana it takes to create until it goes to the default of whatever they are. This is really the only one I got to use this year. So we'll just go ahead and sell it then. I thought I saw something there first for a second. Just buy a couple bandit hands. By a couple, I mean three. Okay, we're just specifically I mean, Coach is good too, but... what is Fist Weapons formula in Disgaea 1? Okay, fists is soul damage, it's just attack. Okay. Okay, so, yeah, okay, yeah, fist weapons in this guy one is specifically attack only. Let's say change it for this one? What I do is, if I don't get what I need to get during the first 10 levels, I'll either reset or I'll just, more than likely, I usually just sell it and just try a different item. It just all depends. Is level 5 for that? Yep, we definitely want you. Okay. Evade on, so this might not go too well. Okay, we got it. A little overkill, but I think we got it. Little overkill, but I think we got it. Yeah, because, yeah, of course. Alright. Depending on who you are, I might not go after you. Yeah, I don't need coach, so. I like that sword. Sure. Oh yeah, I'm supposed to keep an eye out on the items too. Try to steal some stuff. Just stuff that I don't have. If Kat's high enough leveled for it right now. I don't think she is, actually. What is she, level 7? Well, we got the one we wanted. Marksman can be pretty helpful if you're going for a gun build. Which, honestly, Captain Gordon's probably the only one that I would probably concentrate on. Maybe, I don't know. Limit originally was 300, but now they increased it to 900, I want to say? Sorry, I'm just looking up something real quick. Oh, this is a pretty interesting video. Hold on. I'm gonna watch this video later. Have that on the standby. Goes over the differences, so that way we can try to do that. Because I don't think I'm going to reach the cap in this session. With only 15 minutes left. Or a little more than 15 minutes. We'll see. Alright, so we can sell that. Unless that's better. Which it's not. What I need to do is go ahead and put Orange Master on Etna's weapon for right now. Because 11. Well. I don't know. Well, we'll save it. We'll save it. We'll start doing some more stuff tomorrow. Well, no, tomorrow is, well, what is tomorrow, Friday? Yeah, probably doing tomorrow. Do another session tomorrow morning. Because, like I said, I was saying in the beginning of the session, I do want to stream a lot more. Alright, let's see. Common bow, let's go. We can actually put a lot of these out. We just need one at a time. Yeah, we gotta start grinding for money, too. I wish there was a random option. Right off the bat. Is that the one I need, though, is the question. Nope, Marksman. I'm gonna avoid Marksman for right now, because we just don't have Gordon with us. Wait a minute. I thought he could fly through things. Was I mistaken? Oh no. That's bad. I know this guy too had that strategy. Maybe this guy one didn't let you do that. Maybe I was mistaken about that flying stuff. I swear I read that as a strategy somewhere. I don't know. I'm definitely gonna have to do a lot more research. Try to refresh my memory on a lot of this stuff. And actually get to the nitty-gritty about this version. Okay. Suffice to say, we can still throw them though. Go ahead and let it roll. Actually, let's, double check that, too. Yeah, 50% is the max for any non-thief. Okay. Oh. You never know. Thank you. I think we gotta start putting the, whatever session this is in the, stream title. I just wanna see that ridiculous number, like, a ridiculous number at one point, like... Knowing how I play this game, it might very well get to 100 sessions. Hey, but you never know. Innocence can appear on the 10th floor in this guy one, if I'm not mistaken. What is Flan's range? We didn't luck out on that one, so I'll probably just sell that instead of trying again. I don't know if it's just my eyesight, but the blue, I feel like the blue needs to be darker on the, thing. It could be my TV as well, truth be told. Bow of Justice. We'll try the Bow of Justice then. Well, we'll see. It might take long. It might not take long with Bow of Justice. We got the short sword, which... We'll just sell it. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go through some old archives. Do a lot more research. Refresh my memory. I actually have a pretty good disguise strategy guide that I need to look at, too. I might have some stuff. I'm like, I couldn't remember what I was doing. So Bow of Justice might be the last one for the session. Well, I do need to start building up gladiators too at some point. Main focus, we want to mainly focus on the EXP for right now. Level 17, okay. And... Great Wild, okay. Oh, I might exit out of this if this is it. But, I mean, that's the only one. Yeah, I'm gonna use it. 42, that's a good chunk right there. That's also another thing you can do. If you can save and reload if you want to just try to get whatever innocent you want on the first level. I mean, you can do it that way as well. Which is not too bad of an idea with these EXP ones for right now, possibly. I didn't know I had another common axe. Alright. Oh, that's right, you can do that now. I think you might have been able to do that in the original. Oh well. Alright, so we would gain 114% more EXP. Cool. I'm down for that. We got two gladiators already. Yeah, I'm gonna sell the stuff that doesn't have the EXP stuff to it. Yeah. That's that one. Okay. Yeah, we mainly focus on the EXP. Five. Okay, so we'll go through this whole thing. Get another door. She's only level one. There you go. Increase a couple of levels there for you. Don't mind some of the weird stuff I do from time to time. I just have, like, brain farts. We shall do this. Oh, we haven't seen this yet. We'll show this off. We need some EXP. Even just a little bit. It works just like Aetna's whatchamajigget. Pretty bomb. What's the name of that move? Pretty ready. Alright, that didn't look good. Look at that, they increased by 5 levels. Which means Asagi... Nope, no special skill. Okay. Tissues will be nice later for when we grind for armor. So I'll keep a lookout for that.
Thank you.
Oh, dang it, really? Dang it, I messed that up. Oh well. Not Armor Masters, we'll keep that. Let's see what else can happen. And then it's just healing items. Okay. So not that much more we have in storage. You know what? Before I end the session, we will do... first level of this chapter. Because I might grind up to grind some money. Double check if we seen the Han Miser ending or not. I don't think we did, though. I'm just now realizing this is a carbon copy of the first stage in Virus's Castle. Like, I am just now realizing that. Well, this might be a tad bit smaller. Call that a session. Thank you everybody who came out and checked out the stream. this is pretty much going to be it for a majority of these sessions. It's just going to be grinding. There's still some interesting things to go on, though. We got a lot of... We got quite a bit of bonus battles we got to go through. Some bonus party members. And we do got some endings we got to unlock. But for a majority of the first... I don't know how many sessions, it's going to be grinding. So I'm just going to give a heads up to that. I'll definitely put it in the stream title just in case anybody's curious about if it's just going to be nothing but a grind session. Because I have a pretty good hunch when it's going to be a grind session and when it's going to be a new ending. Well, maybe. I don't know. Play by ear. But I'm definitely going to start listening to what session number it is just for funsies. But yeah. Thanks for thanks again to everybody who came out and checked out the stream. Thanks to anybody who comes in and checked out the replay or the upload on YouTube. That's what I meant to say. But yeah, this is just the beginning, and we're already on session 12. But yeah, take easy.